Welcome to my channel. My name is Mildred Lee and I'm gonna it's so messy, my table. I just want to talk about, I'm sorry, I just touched the cable of my cell phone. I'm just gonna put you in my makeshift stand because I need to make a envelope, and I found a beautiful butterfly wing and some kind of blackboard in there. And I thought, if I make an envelope, I don't want to cover it up by doing here a address, and then I'm forced to put some stamps. And I don't want to put stamp on a beautiful piece of text in here. So I thought to myself, why don't I just that's the back side. It's also a beautiful back side. But I need this beautiful close-up of a butterfly wing. And I think I'm gonna grab a paper cutting machine. Oops. Oy. Oy, 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 oy. So I believe this is a cut board. Yes. Oh, there is not. Where's my little? Let's see. Let's check again. I believe, yeah, that's a knife. Where is the? I need to grab the other paper cutting machine. Sorry for that. Sorry for that. Because this is a knob that has a fold knife. So it's not an actually knife. It's just a dull knife. Yeah, that's the one. It's a dull knife. And I won't cut into the paper. One time I did use the wrong cut. I used the wrong paper cutting machine. And I actually cut the whole printed pen and paper. So that's what is taught. That's taught me a lesson to be careful with kind of knife I use to cut. So I have to a couple of times. As you can see, it's very I don't know if you can see it from this side. Here you can see clearly. See? That's the fold. That's what I want. I just want to fold it like so. And I need to know how much paper I need. So this piece of snail mail is very thick. See? It hardly closed. I couldn't even put a clip here to clasp it together. So that is already impossible. So I need to know how much paper I need to... Okay, I have plenty. Okay, so... Let's see. So I don't need to cut it fully on the board. I could have used like a little more over here, but I didn't know how much I need to do fold. So let's see. Where's the line? Here's the line. I'm gonna grab it again because now I have to see. Okay, okay, so I have plenty space, so I can use how much I want. I'm gonna use this much. So this side, I think you saw, can you see? Yes, you can see it here. Do you see the line? If I turn it around, you can see maybe better. There's the line. Can you see the line? So if I fold it, you can see better. Because now it's easy to fold with that dull knife of the paper cutting machine. So, oh, knife. That was wrong. I should have done more. Uh-oh. I made a mistake. How can I remedy that? Can I think if I do? Okay, let's see if I do it better this time. I don't think I did it better this time. But let's see. Almost. Oh no. Doesn't matter. If I did make two mistakes, it's not that serious. Okay. So I want to find some tape to tape it all up, but let's see. I have to tape it here also. On the left and the right side. So what shall I do first? I think I'm gonna show you the total package of the snail mail. So this is the front. So you go here, the actual greeting card, but now I use it as a snail mail. There's a die cut that it's removable. The coloring page, pocket where I've put some stamp sticker washi of Sonja Steegman, a little picture from AliExpress, some kind of booklet. Here is a pocket with some butterfly stamps of Malaysia. Here I'm gonna write something about butterflies. This is an envelope from the greeting card before. I've put a lot of die cuts in there, big and small. This is a sticker that is actually removable, and this is I made a pocket out of emptied bags that I reuse to make my own bag. So I made my own bag topper. I made my own bag topper with one of the die cuts previously, but I used a bug instead of butterfly. Because I didn't want to use all the butterflies. This is the same sticker range or line as of this one, but this has a lot of butterflies in it, and I don't know what I'm gonna write in here. The same with here. This is notepaper. I put only three pieces because there's not so much in this clipboard. So I have this little bit. I didn't know it was so fun to have, to use it. So if I knew I would use that much, I would bought more of these. But that's sometimes a risk you'll take. The print paper that I used previously here on this page that I already glued onto with double-sided tape. On this page, I taped washi tape on there, because this bag needs to be attached on the page. There is this butterfly sequence, so this actually the page is empty, because the on the other side of the page is the butterfly that you can color in. On this page I stuck also a printed paper, but with blue foil, and I thought I don't want to mess up something to add or glue something on this beautiful blue foiled printed paper. So I thought to myself, I'm gonna make some tickets, and I also of the leftover plastic bags I put a long piece of washi tape. It goes way back on the other side, as you can see, almost the same print. And then on this side a little piece of washi tape, and on this page this it has also nothing. But I attached a bag, and I've made, well, I made, I didn't make, but I melted some wax, and I used these. I don't have a lot of butterfly stamp heads, so I used one of the butterfly, one of the heart, one of, I think there's a rose in there, and in this smaller one, oh, out of frame, sorry, it's an angel. So I used those. So, and then you turn this page around Oh, this is nothing. Then I add on the, well, a bag, also a leftover bag, with, I use this bag topper. It says reinforcement ring, because otherwise I'm going to throw it away. So I reuse that little piece of cardboard, and I'm going to show you. I've punched some holes with this puncher. Of course, I could have used the other one. Let's see, where's the other one? Where is the other one? Can't find the other one. Let's see. Where did I put it? I'll just grab another one. Well, smaller than this hole. This is also a puncher, but... like I said, I punched some holes, and I have a box of breads, colorful ones. I've put all of them in here, and I don't want, because the breads are sticking out, if I put it in the bag like this, loose. So I thought, why don't I just open it up from the back side, and I stuck a piece of paper so you can't see all the uglies, the back side. And I wrote the split pins, but in Dutch we call it split pens. So it's a piece of washi tape to cover a piece of sticker. I couldn't remove carefully, so I thought to myself, just stick a piece of washi tape. So, and I add the words breads, so you know that those are breads. I couldn't put it in any of the page, so I thought to myself, as an extra, instead of goodies, I wanted to write extra. I mean the word extras, but I told myself no, the word breads is good enough. So I have to tie it up with a rope. This rope, this thread, I mean, or this one, or with any color, any other color that I have, just to tie it neatly up. But I'm not gonna do that because I need to write some little stories about butterflies in here. And then if I'm really, really done, I need to find some reinforcement cardboard or something. I don't know. Maybe I should use this. I think I can use this. So I need to cut it in half and fold it. This, when this is out, when I cut it out, I want to fold in here. And then I think I will... put it on both sides so I can have an extra piece of paper. So like some kind of flaps, I can fold it like so, and I fold then this piece like so. Oops. And then grab the most thick or sturdy tape, but no, not washi tape, but I think a piece of duct tape. And because here is some piece of thick paper to close everything from left to right. Because the reason why I need duct tape is I want to keep this back side. Actually, this is front side. I want to imagine this is the back side. Because here, the back side becomes the front side. That's the reason why I want to put duct tape. I want to put the address of the snail mail person that I'm going to send this package to. And then I'm going to fluffy and decorate on here. And wait, I need to take out the message. And why keep messages popping up? And then I want to put some stamps here. And then I'm done. So I cannot... say I'm actually done and finished, because I need to do the inside first, thread it up in a bundle. And I'm not sure if I can find something to make it to put an embellishment on the thread, so that will be a little bit more fun. And close it up, and then finally mail it. So that's my take on snail mail and to be realistic, I haven't finished the envelope, but I want to as soon as everything is done. So this is my finished product. My desk is so terrible, so messy. I can show you. You see, that's the messiness of a whole day just doing this only one snail mail. Normally, when I plan things out, how to do snail mail, I can do it within 1.5 hours. But today, just this snail mail, it took me a whole day to make it and to film it. And because sometimes I lost the footage or I corrupted the footage. Well, I not personally, but my cell phone. And today is not, I think it's not a great day of uploading and posting videos. And but still, I managed to finish a snail mail, to be honest. The only thing that I've really lacking of is the personal letter, the favorite list of favorite stuff, and the list of questions and the list of answers. So that's the only 4 things that I need to do to make it all totally 100% finished. So I hope you enjoyed my very long video about prepping, in process, and finishing a butterfly snail mail. I'm gonna end this video, and I wanna thank you for watching all of the vlogs, and thank you for watching them patiently. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye, everyone. Stay safe. Be safe. Bye.